Let's do this.
Gavin's death impacted me in a very bad way because we were very close. We never kept that, you know, thing between us that we are friends. We always treat each other like brothers. And it was like we were blood brothers. So we always, you know, loved each other in a brotherly way. So when he passed away, it came to me as a shock and I was very disheartened, broken.
It was pretty shocking for us at that point in time because no one could actually believe that someone's just gone in an instant like that. So we rushed as soon as possible to see what happened, but he was already long gone since then. That really impacted us as a whole because that's the time Gavin was one of our leaders.
This really made a big, impact. I wouldn't say on the crew because we just started out at that time. I mean, we went from completing Bombay Dreams and we jumped into another theater and Brandon was in there and Dwayne Heckels and all these guys jumped in too. But as a crew, we were never really, you know, there. It was always just me, Donald, Brandon, Gavin. Me, Donald, Brandon, Gavin was never really with so much. And we didn't really pick up as much as a crew in our belief that, you know, that it was going to make an impact on the crew's perspective. But it made a big impact on ours because Donald and I grew really close with the guy. And he was a brother. And, you know, it came out of a shock because we were all in our homes one day with just, you know, doing what we do on a regular basis, either with family or with friends or just ready to go out to train. And we get a call saying, you know, Gavin had a bike accident and he passed away. At that time, the first thing that came to our mind was, what the fuck? You know, because this is not something that we expected. He was perfectly fine the day before we met him. In fact, before he left for that particular bike ride, he called me up and I was with my girlfriend at that time. And he called me up and he was like, "Hey bro, I'm going to with William to Sadar. So you want to meet up over there or you want to come hang out?" I was like, "Nah, I'm good. You know, I'm at home right now." And barely, I think 1 hour, 1.5 hour later, I get a call saying, you know, he's had a really bad bike accident. He's passed away. So it was a lot to deal with at that particular time. We were young. We didn't know what the feeling was, whether it was, you know, something serious or, you know, something that, you know, he could make it out of, because we didn't really understand that factor of, you know, he's had a bike accident, he's critical. So it was very confusing. And then, you know, we went over to his place. We were sitting there with Milagreen and auntie and uncle, and those days just felt like everything went to a standstill. Like the crew, the dancing, none of that mattered anymore. I mean, it just felt like, you know, going to Frey Hall to train or just generally continue dancing just didn't feel, you know, regular anymore.
But that didn't stop me from continuing what he wanted. He always wanted us to be the best we were in our dancing careers. So that's what motivated us to go on ahead. He would never want us to stop and moan and, you know, give that gap. He would definitely wanted us to continue, work harder and dance better and become better dancers. And this is the reason why, which motivated us a lot to go ahead to Act One, compete in that and win that. And plus, during that time, we were doing another show. So we did our best in that show as well, and people did recognize us more after that.